now that I'm back inside of my laptop, I'm going to select a plugin. I kind of want to create a sort of a world music rhythm to this track just to give it a little more vibe. So I'm going to open the SRX Dance Tracks by Roland Cloud. This used to be an expansion board for our products back in the day. I'm going to hover over to the Haiti 120. Now this is going to give me the BPM over here. And since I already know the key, I'm just going to draw in the D sharp here. So now that I've brought the volume of the sample all the way down, I'm going to press play, and then all I'm going to hear is the drum sound with this virtual instrument loop. I'm going to bring the volume of the sample back up. Now that's cool, but the drums sound a little stale. So what I'm going to do is add a little bit of swing inside of Serato Studio. So if we look back to our laptop here, I'm going to click the 909 drums and I'm going to move this swing knob to about 20%. We're going to play back the track and it should give us a little bit of a better groove. There we go. It's a little less robotic. So quick tip, again, if you're new to production, what swing is, it gives you a little bit more of a human feel to your track. So even though we're using quantization, swing will give us a bit more of that human feel back because it'll randomize where those notes that we've quantized previously, and it'll make it feel as if it's a real drummer hitting those drums. So now that we've crafted a really quick beat, what I want to do now is put my two scenes into song mode so I don't have to manually press the scenes on the right side of the deck. So I'm going to go over into the song view button and press the song mode. And I'm going to click and drag these two bars into the timeline. And now as I press play, it's going to write to the master track. So now that I've brought over my scenes, what I can do from here is export the track. So I'm going to go over to File all the way at the top left, and I can export the song. And I get two choices. I can either export the master or I can export the stems. Now you would export the stems if you wanted to mix further in a DAW like Pro Tools or Logic or Ableton, maybe Cubase, whatever you utilize. Or you can just export the master from here. And let's say I wanted to save this as a wave. I can select a folder that I want and then call it. I'm going to call it beat. It's great that it doesn't have to render in real time. That's awesome. So now that I've exported that really basic project, I have my very first track. So that's how easy it is. If you're starting out as a DJ, you can now utilize your DJ-202 to use it as a production workstation with Serato Studio. It's that easy. Thanks for watching the How to Use the DJ-202 with Serato Studio. If you guys like this video, feel free to join us on the Roland DJ-202 Cloud Academy course that's absolutely free and taught by Roland product specialists like myself. We'll catch you soon.